Hey Savvy Devs, it's Savvy Nick here, and today we'll be going through how to install XTix. We'll first download it, then I'll explain how to flash it onto a disk, we'll boot that disk, and finally run through how to install it on an empty storage space of your choice. If you're new and stopping by to watch an install today, please take a moment to subscribe below and hit the notification bell for more videos. I'm here on the XTix website, where I'm going to go ahead and download XTix from. Now if we look down here, we have just recently received a new build from XTix with Deepin as the default desktop environment here. You can go ahead and read about this new release and all the new functions that comes with it. Some new things, it looks like you can run XTix from RAM, which is really nice. And it looks like there's a new installer, which they claim works better in every way. A few more programs have come pre-installed now. So let's go ahead and download. So we'll go to the download section up top. And down here, we can go ahead to the download section. And it says that you can download XTix from SourceForge. So we're gonna go ahead and use SourceForge. And here on the SourceForge website, we're gonna go ahead and hit the green download button. And just wait here for a moment before it begins downloading. And once it's begin downloading, you'll see it at the bottom here. Give this a few minutes, and then we're gonna go ahead and flash this image onto a disk. Now that I've downloaded the ISO, I'm gonna go ahead and launch the Balena Etcher app. So let's just search for Balena Etcher and start it. I'm going to use this app in order to flash the image onto a USB, CD, or DVD of my choice. Balena Etcher is an easy to use application available for Windows, Mac, and Linux. I'll go ahead and put a link in the description below if you wanna download the application. You can also use any other application that can create a bootable disk such as UNetBootin or Rufus. Go ahead and first hit the Select Image button. And here you'll go ahead and select the image that we just downloaded. So as you can see, it says XTix 20.1 64-bit Deepin version. That's the one we want, so let's go ahead and open that up. Following that, we're going to go ahead and insert a USB, CD, or DVD of our choice into the computer, and it will be automatically recognized by Balena Etcher if there's no other USB, CD, or DVD inside the system. You can also hit the change button and change between multiple USBs if you do have more than one. Make sure to select the proper one because whatever is currently on the USB, CD, or DVD will get erased and written over by the XTix installer. So go ahead once you've confirmed you have the proper USB, CD, or DVD selected. Also give it permission in order to go ahead and run Balena Etcher and flash. After you flash the disk, you'll take it over to a computer or server where you want to install XTix on and then insert it. After that, you'll have to boot into your BIOS in order to change the boot order around and select a newly created bootable disk to be the first to boot. This is usually done by finding the correct key to boot into your BIOS for your particular computer. It's usually one of the F keys like F2 or F10. Then you'll find a tab usually called boot order and exchange the order so that the bootable disk is first to boot. After you have that set up, you will save and exit out of your BIOS and you should see a screen similar to this if you did everything correctly. If you went ahead and made it this far, please hit the like button. It really does help me out. All right, and if you see this screen, you've successfully made it to the install portion. Let's go ahead and select the XTix Deepin default. This should boot us into the live media for XTix, where we can go ahead and select to install it. Give it a few moments here in order to boot the live system. And once the system has booted into the live disk, in the upper left-hand corner, you'll see Install Deepin icon. So go ahead, double-click that icon and let it start the installer. And the first thing that we're gonna go ahead and select is what language we want to install with. So I'm gonna go ahead and select English, and then I'm gonna go ahead and agree to the user license agreement. Friendly reminder is just that I'm using a virtual machine to install this. It doesn't really matter what you use, but it says just to expect a different system performance because I'm using a virtual machine. Up in the top left, you can go ahead and select a different type of keyboard if you want. Mine is the default English US, which is fine. You can also test your keyboard in here. So I typed in QWERTY and it came out QWERTY, so I know everything's all right. Once you're finished selecting your keyboard, you can go ahead and hit back. And now we can create a user. My user is gonna be Savvy Nick. And my PC name is going to be Savvy Nick or the host name. And go ahead and put a password in and confirm that password. Hit the next button when you're ready. Go ahead and select an area that you're by, so I can select the proper time zone. Denver works fine for me. Go ahead and hit next after that. And now you have to select where you want to install XTix on. And there are three different options. You can use the full disk method, the simple method, or the advanced method. I'm just gonna go ahead and use the simple method. It has detected that there's a 32 gigabyte storage space available, and it says that there's free space here, and it says nothing has been used up of those 32 gigabytes, which is great for me because I have a fresh storage space. Now you'll wanna make sure that you use a storage space where you don't care that where all your data will be wiped off of, because it says right up here that make sure that you have any backed up important data before you install to the disk, because the installer will wipe everything that's currently on the disk that you have selected. So make sure you also select the correct disk. Go ahead and click on the disk if you have multiple, the one where you want to install XTix on, and then you can go ahead and hit start the installation. Following this, it just says that it's preparing for the installation and what it's gonna do as far as the installation goes. It's just gonna format the disk, create a MDOS partition table, as well as format the new partition as type ext. So this is fine for us. And at this point, there's no going back. So again, make sure that you don't mind all the data and anything that's on the current disk that you have selected being erased. And after you've confirmed that, you can go ahead and hit continue. And at this point, the installer has begun. XTix is a Linux distribution based on Debian. It offers multiple different types of desktop environments, including Deepin, Budgie, KDE, and LXQT. It's been around since 08 and offers a 64-bit architecture for its users to install. The latest version features a new installer and an updated Deepin desktop environment. Also, this distribution can be stored and ran from physical memory if necessary, which allows the system to have a very quick response time. That's definitely something nice if you want to go ahead and dive into that. We'll go ahead and give this a few more moments in order to finish up. And at this point, the installer is done. And while rebooting, you'll want to make sure to go ahead and remove any installation media, as it says here, that you may have in your computer so that you don't boot back into the installer or the live image of the system. Otherwise, you'll have to reboot once more and take out the media in order to get to your newly installed system. Let's go ahead and hit experience now. And once the system is finished rebooting, you'll get a login screen, but it currently has a live user selected, so I assume that's a guest user. What we want is a user that we created, so let's go ahead and hit this little icon here of the people, and then go ahead and click on your username that you created. Put your password in, and let the system load up real quick. And here we are. We've now successfully installed the XTix Deepin desktop system. Let's just go ahead and explore just a little bit. We have a dock at the bottom here that we can explore. We have a launcher, as well as a multitasking view. If we click that, that just gives us multiple desktops here. And then we have a file manager, as well as an app store, a music player, video player, settings, or the control center, and then what the current volume is, as well as what the wired connection or wireless connection would be. We can use this button in order to expand or collapse items inside of here, and then to power on and off the system, as well as the current time and date, and if you need to throw anything away in the trash. You can also go ahead and create files on the main desktop here if you want to. And if you hit the launcher, it's much like the start menu. And you can search through different subcategories here if you hit the all categories. And then if you go back, it's just some of your favorite applications that you've used or common ones that you will use. That was just a quick run through of the desktop environment here. I hope you enjoyed this installation tutorial of XTix Linux. And if you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, please post them in the comments section below. Also, make sure to subscribe for future videos and make sure to like the video. Thanks for watching.